So, what we'll do is, in the same administration block under course administration, under users you have groups. Please, can I have your attention? Under course administration you have groups. Please click on the groups link. Now we'll group all your students into two groups. So, are you on in the same link? Say on the same under course administration? Yes. Please stop us if you are not following, if you are not in sync with us, please. It's very useful for group and collaborative projects, group assignments. Okay? So if you scroll on, just scroll down. We have two options for creating groups. Either manually you can, generally I prefer auto create groups. Okay? Click on the button auto create groups. Yes. If you scroll down, auto create groups. Found it? Yeah. Please click on the button. And here, just scroll up. Here you have the naming scheme. If you use this at the rate, it will give us group ABC. If you want group 1, 2, 3, you change that to hash. Please click on this help icon. Here it says, if you use this symbol, at symbol, you will get group ABC. Whereas if you use hash, you can change. Okay. 1, 2, 3 and all. And number of groups or members per group. We have only two. So, members per group, both ways you can group your students. Members per group and we have four. So, specify here two. And you also have, if you scroll down randomly, generally we prefer randomly or alphabetically. Something is there. You come out of that. Here one more option is there. Sometimes what happens, say for example you have 51 students. So here you specify 5 students in each group. So what will happen to the last one, 51? In that scenario you need to check this box that 51 will be added to any of these groups. Okay, if you have this, we don't have any. Okay, yes, yeah. Okay. You can preview the groups. Click on the button preview. Scroll down and you can preview. Scroll down, scroll down. So these are all the groups with two students. Done? Okay. Then click on the button submit. That's it. Now we are ready with two groups with two students. Any issue here? If you click on group, then you will get to know how many students on the right side you have, members in each group. Now, we want a forum to use this group's functionality. So, what shall we do? Come back to your course page. Why do you want to go always? No, please never use, go back to, always use this breadcrumb trail. It tells us the path. Where are we? See, it says this is your course page under users under group space. Always use this. If you want to move to any other course, then use my courses or something. Okay. So, please come back to your main course page and go to any module or week or any chapter or topic, whatever you are following, and click on add an activity or resource and forum. So now you will be having one learning support forum that will not be considered under activities, one general article reflection on general article, and one video based or anything. Third will be group forum, please remember. Now we are creating a forum, forum name, group project, group discussion, whatever it may be, I don't know, you know better than me. Okay, description, you know, all these instructions can be given once we start creating separate discussions. Use this forum, just give, use this forum for group discussion, that's it. Yeah, expand all as always. scroll down. Use this as it is standard forum so that we can create different discussions. If you want to disable this, uploads are not allowed. If you want, it's you can decide on this. And this is post subscription. Under subscription mode, change that to post subscription. Scroll down. This is not for rating purpose, only group discussion. No, we are not rating. And any other? Yeah, under this you need to add, just scroll up. No, not here. Scroll up to groups. Here we have, please all of you scroll down to this area, that is common module settings. So here we have two types, separate groups and visible groups. Please click on this question mark. So here it gives, separate group means students cannot view others discussions. Visible groups means they can view others discussions, but they cannot participate. So which one do you prefer? Separate? Okay, then separate groups. We don't have groupings again under, no, here we it's not required for assignment. We'll do wiki under, scroll down and save and display. Here we have all participants or groups. Okay, from here you can pick up the group from here, or while creating add a new discussion topic also we can do. Click on a group and create a discussion thread for them. Add a new discussion topic. What is this? So if you scroll down fully, and here from here also you can pick up, either before initiating the thread or from here also you can pick up. Okay, so different questions, even say if it is the same question, or you can use both ways. So pick up the group from here. Already picked up group, huh? Okay, so here your instructions to your students, what you are expecting. Sorry? Whenever mail now, but generally your administrators, they don't prefer. So server will be overloaded every 15 minutes. I don't know whether at regular intervals cron is running or not. Whenever that cron runs, automatically all these will be pushed to their email. Don't click on mail now. Done. Then again one more thread for the second group. Create one more. Yeah, click on post to forum. Continue. Then initiate one more for group B. Yes. This is one advantage of using forums for group discussions. Whereas if you use wiki, you need to create multiple wikis, multiple instances of wiki. Whereas coming to forum, you can create one forum, you can initiate different threads for different groups. That is. Why you are using shortcuts, only single word, no instructions for your students. They are recording this, so. After this, all your videos will be used for reference purpose. What happened? Now you show all, I want all these, no? All participants, no, all participants, click on all participants, what will happen? We don't have anything. Yeah, so we have for group A and for group B two discussion forums. Then who all are your students? Group A and group B. Now click on right click on it and open it, group B and group A also. In all of you, please pull it down and click on all participants so that we'll be able to see the groups we have created. So right click on the forum from here, all participants. No, for not right click this, yes. All participants we want, so that the all the groups will be visible here. Now right click on a group and open link in a new tab, two groups. Who is in group? Not all participants. From here you can select, from here. Student groups are there, no? Groups are not there. Or from either go to users and groups, click on participants. Here all participants. Yeah, we need to do one more step is there. To view the groups of participants, students from this participants list, you go to course edit settings, click on your course page, then we will be able to see who all are in the different groups. Where is edit settings? In the administration block we have course edit settings. Yeah, edit settings, so that we can see all your participants either on the grade book or on the participants list. Expand all, scroll down to groups area, scroll down. Where is that? Yes, here separate groups. Never make this S. We want activity level groups. In Moodle we have either activity level, course level, but generally we separate groups here. The reason we want to see the groups of students on the participants list and grade book, only for that. If you force this, so whenever you create activity and separate groups and all, then it will not take. So never make this no, yes, never make this yes. Just simply change the group mode to separate groups, scroll down and save. Now you click on the participants in the navigation block. Yeah, now click on the link in the navigation block, participants link. Now you can pull it down and check from the list. This one? Here, all participants. Yeah. From here, you can even students can see. So now you request your student. So request your student to click on your course under My Courses. And click on this group discussion forum. And you are the student of which? You are the student of which course? Which course? So from My Courses, go there. Click on their course. Yeah. So please, as a student, go to their particular course. Your colleague's course and click on the group discussion forum. Only two can see. Yeah. Now click on the thread and post something. Reply. Click on reply and post something. How do you differentiate between? Okay. I need your help to get an answer for this. I need to know more about this. So please, all of you, go to your student course page and click on the discussion forum created by your teacher and post something.